faith, and above all, hope. After the presentation, I will be pleased to answer some of your questions. And at this point, I also would like to welcome the members of the community, parents, and all of you are here at this point. Life in the early 1930s in Germany was very much for my family as it is here for most of you today. Never did we think that the anti-Semitic incidents there would ever lead to very much. My father was in a successful shoe business in a small town. My parents, 2-year older brother and I, lived comfortably with my grandparents above the shoe store. Life for Jews was made increasingly more difficult. And in 1935, the Nuremberg Laws were formulated and enforced. The following are just some of the many restrictions imposed on the Jews in Germany. Jews were not allowed into theaters, into parks, or into swimming pools. All public schools were closed to Jewish children. Then there was the evening curfew for the Jews. Jews were only allowed to shop during specific hours of the day, and non-Jews were not allowed to shop in Jewish-owned stores. Non-Jews were just not allowed to associate with Jewish people. And then a big letter J for Jew was stamped on ID cards and on passports. These restrictions went on and on. And it was then that my parents decided to make arrangements to leave the country. My grandparents, who in the late 70s and ill, refused to leave their home. They could not understand the urgency or the necessity of doing so. My grandparents passed away in 1938, just 11 days within each other. And soon thereafter, we received our necessary papers for our immigration to America. I was just 4 years old at that time. November 9, 1938, Kristallnacht, or Kristallnacht. It was the night of broken glass when the Nazis and their followers smashed the windows and the storefronts of Jewish-owned stores. Jewish establishments, synagogues, and Jewish books were burned and destroyed. This was the beginning of a massive pogrom against the Jews in Germany, a massive verbal and physical assault against all German Jews. In reality, this was the beginning of the Holocaust. On November 12th, following Kristallnacht, the German government actually fined the Jewish population for the damage caused that night. These imposed taxes were used to rearm Germany. The night of Kristallnacht, my father was taken away from our home, and unbeknownst to my mother, was sent to concentration camp Buchenwald in Germany. All sorts of terrible stories were related to my mother, and we did not know we would ever see my father again. He was released after 10 days, only because our papers were in order for our immigration to America. And to think that just a few years prior, he had been awarded the Iron Cross for his military service in the German Army of World War I. We were forced to sell both our home and our business for a fraction of its worth. And soon thereafter, in January of 1939, we left for Holland, from where we were to sail to the United States. And for almost 9 months, while awaiting our quota number from the American State Department, my parents were assigned to take care of some 125 children. These young children had been sent by their parents from various parts of Europe to escape from the Nazis. In December of that year, 1939, we were deported to the detention camp of Westerbork in Holland to await our departure day to America. Camp Westerbork was constructed by the Dutch to accommodate Jews from various parts of Europe. In May of 1940, just 1 month before our planned departure day, the Germans invaded Holland and we were trapped. All of our belongings, which were about to be loaded on board ship, were burned and destroyed as the harbor of Rotterdam.